British playwright Mark Ravenhill recently rejoined Twitter, and he's reignited his Twitter presence by tweeting 101 playwriting tips. These are bite-sized writing prompts that are so inspiring and easily usable if you're writing or devising work. Here are 10 of my favourites so far. Just rediscovered what I rediscover every time. Cut the first 6 pages of the draft of the play and the last page. The first 6 pages are more of a warm-up and the last page is a victory lap come down. With these cut, you can see more clearly what the play is. A play often progresses by the characters choosing to say, either directly or in so many words, yes or no to an offer of action. If you get stuck, look at changing a no to a yes or vice versa and explore the consequences. Characters asking questions is often the engine of a play. When writing, rewriting, see if you can frame lines as questions and explore the consequences. Could the first line of your play be a question? Could the last line of the play be a... Try writing a draft zero, dirty draft. Let the characters say all the exposition, themes, everything they think and feel. Don't show this to anyone, even yourself. And then write the first draft. Sarah Kane told me she did this for Blasted. An incredible number of plays over the centuries begin with the same situation. Two or more characters anticipate the arrival of another character. Worth thinking, who would anticipate the arrival of who in the opening of your next play? A teacher in school told us drama is conflict. When I started to write plays, I found this led only to scenes of characters arguing. When I tried writing deferred conflict, conflict avoided until it was the only thing possible, I found this more productive. A new character entering should be like someone stepping into a dinghy. Everyone in the dinghy has to reposition themselves to find a new balance or they'll capsize. The action of the scene is the negotiation of that repositioning. Same for an exit. I cut the first word of many lines. That last bit of fear of committing to the action of the line has a put in a well or a but or just. In rehearsals, actors sometimes unconsciously put back in that little thing before a line. I try to discourage them. I try to find a strong word to put at the end of the line, that final pulse of energy that allows the actor to bat it over the net and makes it a strong offer to the other actor. Going through a draft, I look at each line, rearrange words to achieve this. Scene treading water because two characters are locked in opposition. Find a point 3/4 of the way into the scene and flip the dialogue. Give them each other's lines. It'll create a false reversal, but it'll give you ideas for writing a genuine one. And finally, Mark says, exciting that some of you teachers out there are using these tweeted notes in the classroom. They are all intended as prompts, of course, not rules. Select, modify, or discard. Find out what works for you and feedback any discoveries. Get following him on Twitter. He's Mark Ravenhill too, and he's tweeting tips all the time. I'll link his profile in the description below. And check out his plays too. They include Shopping and Fucking, Some Explicit Polaroids, Paul, No Water, and Citizenship, and Shoot, Get, Treasure, Repeat. Shoot, Get, Treasure, Repeat is a personal favourite of mine. It's an epic cycle of short plays that explore the personal and political effect of war on modern life. Also, Mark's been recently appointed as co-artistic director alongside Hannah Price of the King's Head Theatre in London. So watch this space for his first season announcement. Thanks for watching. If this video helped you, please give it a like, make sure you hit subscribe and ding the bell too. And check out these other videos that I think you'll enjoy. All the best.